iPadOS 26 completely rewrites how users can interact with their iPad. It's finally giving power to those that want it. But for those that want a simple, straightforward tablet experience to do some online shopping, surf the web, or play some games, it can still be that simple of an experience. I've been using iPadOS 26 on my main machine here for over a month and a half now, ever since WWDC, and I've been loving every minute of it. Despite the fact that it is still in beta, there are bugs, iPadOS 26 has completely changed the way I interact with my iPad. Now, I'm still going to have my full detailed iPadOS walkthrough in the fall when iPadOS 26 ships to everybody, but right now, I want to focus on the big key changes of iPadOS 26 and how they affect power users and the little details that you may not know. This video is sponsored by Surfshark. Let's start by talking about the biggest aspect of iPadOS 26. That is the new windowing mode. For me and other iPad power users like me, this is going to be game-changing. When launching any app for the first time with the new windowing mode enabled, it will launch full screen. You will see a resize icon in the bottom right hand corner. Drag that and the app will go into the window mode. If you have any other apps in the window mode already, it will just join them in that space. Now, what's great about this is the iPad remembers both its position and scale for the window. If you minimize, close, or even reboot your iPad, when you go to open that app back up, it will be in the same spot and the same size as it was previously when it was opened. This means I'm not spending time setting up my windows every time I sit down to do administrative tasks, to write, or just scroll through the feeds. I'm sitting down, tapping on an app, and just getting to work. The system remembers where I like the window to be placed and the size it should be. Another huge improvement is the amount of apps you can have open at once. Now, on my M4 iPad Pro, I can have 12 app windows open at one time. Now, this number does change based on the model and how much RAM your iPad has. As you hit that number, it closes out the oldest window automatically. This has been such a boost to my workflow. I'm able to keep a lot of apps open, and rarely do I ever keep 12 open at once or do I need 12 open at once, but I definitely need more than the 4 that Stage Manager was giving me. Being able to have lots of apps open, reference information, drag and drop files, move between workflows has been killer. Working this way has been aided by the fact that Apple increased the number of apps you can have in the dock at once. On my 13-inch iPad Pro, I was able to add 12 apps in the dock, and that's not even counting the 3 folders, but more on that in a bit. Now, this is my primary app switcher, because when you tap on an app, it just opens now with the rest of your apps now. No separate space, everything is just in one place. Because of this, I make sure none of my windows are covering my dock. If they do, the dock automatically hides, but you can bring the windows up from the bottom and the dock will be visible. If the dock is hidden, you could swipe up from the bottom to reveal it as well. Because of the amount of apps I was able to add to the dock, this makes for the best way for quickly launching my most used apps. Once the window is open, I've been using the new stoplight controls to manage it. These are the same controls you get in macOS, but with iPadOS, they stay small and out of the way until you tap on them. The green control will let you jump back to a full screen mode for an app. Yellow minimizes an app so that you can open it back up and it will have the same content displayed. Then the red button kills the app, so when you open it again, it relaunches and starts from scratch. Each of these have their use and have been extremely helpful over this beta period. If you long press on the stoplight controls, you get the new tiling options for windows. The top row will move and resize the window that you have selected. The bottom row moves and resize windows that you have opened in the space. This is based on your most recently used apps. There are options for 2 apps side by side or top and bottom here, but one of my favorite additions is the 3 column mode. This will put the last 3 apps you have used into 3 different columns next to each other. When using apps in column mode, there is a familiar UI element. The split view slider is here so you can resize your apps at once. It's a nice touch because it adjusts both apps that are side by side at once. It even appears in that 3 column mode I mentioned. This video is sponsored by Surfshark. Surfshark is a VPN service that not only protects you, but your data. With Surfshark, your traffic is completely encrypted from your device to its destination, protecting your privacy. Whether you're connecting to a public Wi-Fi network in a coffee shop or connecting to the internet in a hotel, your data and privacy is secure. This isn't a, well, I have nothing to hide, so I have nothing to lose kind of thing. Data's the new gold, and some scary people will do scary things to get a hold of that. Something I really appreciate about Surfshark is they don't keep logs. Keeping logs defeats the purpose of using a VPN. You can even use Surfshark to check out price discriminations based on regions. And with Surfshark, you can use it to change your location. So, say you're traveling abroad, you want to remote back into your home country and finish a TV show. Or say you're in the US and you want to check out what UK Netflix has to offer. You can do that as well. I really like Surfshark. In fact, as a service, I pay for myself. I'm about ready to kick off a whole bunch of summer travel, and I have Surfshark installed on all my computers that are coming with me. Go to surfshark.com/lolly or use code lolly at checkout to get an extra 4 months of Surfshark for free. My thanks to Surfshark for sponsoring this video. The stoplight controls aren't the only way to manage a window. There is now a menu bar to control apps. Just swipe down from the top of the iPad or push your cursor up into the top. In here, you will see controls for the app you are currently using. Stuff like editing text, opening a new window, controls within the app, plus you will see all the keyboard shortcuts for that app as well. There is also a menu tab dedicated to window management. There are a few options in here that aren't in the spotlight controls, including a center option, move to display, this is if you're using an external display, and under the move and resize menu, there is a quarters option for four windows at once. Most of these controls under the menu bar have keyboard shortcuts attached to them. A few of my favorites are globe control right and left arrow to move a window to the side and make it a 50% view. Globe control shift right and left arrow does the same thing, but it arranges the two most recently used windows into a 50-50 view. Globe control C centers a window, and command M minimizes a window. iPadOS 26 overhauls the mouse cursor as well. It's now more pointy and in line with a traditional mouse cursor. This helps with precision of using the mouse with an iPad. I never hated the old round version, but once I started using Final Cut and Photoshop on the iPad a lot more, its finickiness shined through. Now where the point is what will be clicked, select, highlighted, or any other verb you want to use. There is also the Shake to Enlarge feature for macOS on the iPad now. So if you tend to lose the cursor, just shake your mouse or trackpad and the cursor will grow. Shortcuts got a few new actions in iPadOS 26, but in this video, I want to highlight just one, and that is the Use Model action. This allows you to essentially use a chatbot right inside Shortcuts. There are three different models you can use with this. First is the on-device model. This is a small model that can process small tasks, but it does everything local and stays on-device. It also works offline as well. Then there is the private cloud compute option. This uses Apple's larger model and connects to their private servers. It handles bigger tasks, but obviously requires an internet connection. The third model is ChatGPT. This obviously connects to ChatGPT servers and can handle much larger tasks than the Apple models. I've personally been favoring the private cloud compute option as I've been playing with this. It strikes a good balance of being able to handle certain tasks while still being fast. With this action, I've updated my Capture Cut shortcut to do automatic tagging, built out a shortcut for Todoist to help me quickly add tasks, and more. What's really impressive about this action is it outputs shortcuts variables. So what this means is you could have this filter, you know, your task manager's tasks or your calendars, and have it filtered by certain categories or certain specific requirements. Or you could do what I'm doing with Capture Cut and have it do automatic tagging and then be able to put all that text together in a text action. There's so many things you can do with this because it can output shortcuts variables. It can just work with your normal shortcuts. It's not just outputting text. Now, I'm going to do a whole video about shortcuts in these 26 OS updates because there is a lot of good stuff in here. I'm really impressed with the use model action, but there is some other things like transcribed audio actions, writing tool actions. The old split view actions now work with the new windowing multitasking mode in iPadOS. There's actually quite a bit here in shortcuts for iPadOS and iOS 26. I would probably say this is the biggest update in years. Files also got some huge improvements with iPadOS 26. First, the list view got overhauled with collapsible folders. You can double click or select a folder and open that folder just like you could previously, but now you can use the arrow keys on a keyboard to navigate through the files and folders. My favorite new feature in Files, though, is you can long press or right-click on a file, and there is a new Open With menu. Here you can pick from a list of apps that can open this file type. No more having to delete apps until the file opens in the right place. Now, Apple even took it a step further, and if you go into the Get Info panel, you can set a default app. When changing this, it will ask if you want to change it for just this file or for all files with this file type. This change alone makes Files so much more useful. Now, when I tap on a file, I know it's going to open in the right app. I don't have to do a weird dance to try and get it into a specific PDF viewer or a specific Word document app or anything like that. I alluded to this earlier, you can now add folders to the dock of iPadOS. Just drag and drop the folder right out of Files into your dock. I've added my Documents folder, my Downloads folder, and my Video Projects folder. Another feature that affects Files a bit, but isn't just restricted to it, is the new Background Tasks feature. This gives apps the ability to still handle tasks after an app has been minimized or moved to the background. For example, transferring files to an external drive or downloading files from Safari can now be handled in the background. If you start one of these tasks and then close the app, a live activity will start and will show the progression of that task. Third-party apps will be able to update in the fall to support this, so other file management apps, other web browsers, things like that will be able to do these tasks as well, along with creative apps that do large exports and things like that. Speaking of which, Apple announced the WWDC Final Cut Pro for the iPad will get an update in the fall to support background tasks. So that way, when you're exporting video, you can just move on to other tasks. I'm very much looking forward to this. I got really used to starting an export of video or downloading large files, and I just had to let my iPad sit there. I had to stop working and just let my iPad do that single task, which was kind of ridiculous. Now I'll be able to move on and work on a thumbnail or a video description while a video is being exported. The last feature I want to talk about is the new Preview app. The iPad finally has a native way of dealing with PDF documents or opening images without adding them to your photo library by default. I'm so excited about this. The Preview app is a really good iPad citizen. It has all the features you would expect from the Mac Preview app, so it has the ability to add text fields and signatures, autofill forms, and even has search. It also has support for the whole Pencil Kit toolset, which means you can draw, mark up, or add shapes to any document. Preview on the iPad is filling a huge gap. Sure, there are a half a billion PDF apps on the App Store, but a lot of them are chocked full of ads. Some of them are kind of scammy or buggy, and others just don't work very well. They're just like generic PDF readers that were slapped together, and they don't really have any editing capabilities. This right here is a native iPad citizen. It is a system app. It is there when you update to iPadOS 26. It will be there right from the get-go. You will be able to handle PDF documents and images right from the Files app, right from mail or anything like that. I'm very excited that this is finally here. Now, there is a lot more to cover with iPadOS 26. Seriously, I am just scratching the surface. I cannot stress this enough, but come September, when iPadOS 26 ships to everyone, I will have a massive walkthrough out. I always do every year, and it's always one of my favorite videos to put together. It's always the biggest video I put together every year. So be sure to subscribe for that, but I'm also going to have a few other videos about iPadOS 26 before then. Like, one that I'm working on right now is kind of like my iPadOS 26 workflow and like how I've changed using external monitor support and even a little bit of Stage Manager and some stuff like that. My thanks to Surfshark for sponsoring this video. If you liked the video, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't already, and have a great day.